Hey guys, welcome back to Six Sister Stuff. Today I'm making the best chili in the Instant Pot. So I'm Kristen, I am the second sister from SixSistersStuff.com. And every Monday I'm sharing with you a new Instant Pot recipe. So today I'm sharing with you my mom's Instant Pot chili. Now this is her normal chili recipe, so if you don't have an Instant Pot, don't worry, I got you covered. So down below in the description I have a printable recipe for the Instant Pot chili. I also have a printable recipe for the slow cooker chili. And if you're running out of time, I also have a video that you can make it on the stovetop. So I've got everything covered. So every single year on Halloween, my mom made this chili, and I decided to make it this year for my kids, but this time in the Instant Pot. Now, Halloween is my most favorite holiday. We started doing family-themed costumes a few years ago, so these are just a few of them. From superheroes and villains, to a Star Wars theme where I was 8 months pregnant and the perfect BB-8. Last year was The Wizard of Oz in Texas, and this year in Sacramento is Mario themed. So now I hope you all had a wonderful Halloween. Now let's jump into the kitchen and make this delicious Instant Pot chili. Now, if you want to cook your hamburger in your Instant Pot, you can. All you have to do is push the saute button, put your meat in there. I would also put your onions in there, and you'll cook them together. But it's Halloween, things are crazy, so I cooked my meat in advance. I'll put a link in the description for you on how to cook it inside your Instant Pot. Now, onto the chili. I have 1 pound of cooked ground beef. I have 3 stalks of celery that I chopped up, and then 1 whole onion. You don't have to use a whole onion. I just like onions, so I like to do the whole thing. On top of that, you're gonna add 1 can of kidney beans. I use dark kidney beans, and I drained them, rinsed them and drained them. Then you have 8 ounces of tomato sauce and 2 cans of diced tomatoes just thrown right on top. Now with one of those cans of diced tomatoes, I just filled up about 1/2 cup of water and dumped it in the pot. Now the next thing is 1/4 cup of ketchup. You can measure if you want. I just always eyeball my ketchup. This next step is optional, but my mom always does it, so you add 1 tablespoon of sugar. Then 2 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce. Worcestershire, Worcestershire, lots of comments about that one. You can say it how you want. I call it Worcestershire sauce. So you can mix it around a little bit if you want to, but it's all pressurizing together, so I just put the lid on. Make sure your little knob is on sealing, not venting. Then I'm using, of course, the manual button. So if you have a different Instant Pot, you use pressure cook, just anything to make it pressurized, just normal. And you're gonna cook it for 10 minutes. Now you can turn the knob and let the pressure release, or you can let it release on its own. Now the chili is all the way done. You're gonna just mix it up a little bit. Now I'm curious what you guys like to serve on your chili. We always serve ours with Frito chips, with cheese, and then breadsticks and salad on the side. And that was our Halloween meal. All right, you guys, thanks so much for joining me today on this Instant Pot Monday. Now, if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe and push that little bell so you can get all my new Instant Pot recipes. All right, you guys, I'll see you later this week. Bye.